and the backdrop gently slide into the sea and shape a rocky and fragmented coastline rich in inlets and hidden bays. If you happen to come into this part of the world during March or April, you can ski in the morning up in the mountains and then swim in the lukewarm waters of this turquoise sea late in the afternoon. Quite a rare opportunity. Another area worth visiting is Kaleiichi Marina. An old berg crossed by lanes among wooden houses built on rocky cliffs. Here are the most beautiful mosques in town and the best preserved archaeological sites. Pretty much like in the rest of Turkey, but here we can find a series of historical ruin layers. The walls of the 2nd century BC built by Attila II, king of Pergamos. The three-arch door built for the Emperor Hadrian's visit to Antalya in 130 AD. And even ruins left by the Byzantines and the Seleucides, a Turkish dynasty led by Seleuk, the great commander who converted to the Islamic religion and conquered the Bukhara region. Moreover, the town offers a series of relevant cultural and entertainment events. Aspendos's ancient open-air theater holds concerts and performances at an international level. Every June, there's the opera and the International Ballet Festival, attracting thousands of visitors. Film festivals, the Archaeological Museum, and obviously the Atatürk Museum, exhibiting writing objects belonging to the founder of the Turkish Republic, Mustafa Kemal Atatürk, still beloved and worshipped by the entire population. From Antalya, we drive approximately 40 kilometers through woods and mountains and arrive at Kemer, another important seaside resort. Here, the marina is also very well set up and offers a magnificent beach recommended by and blue marked in the EU listing. A pristine environment, where hotel buildings and tourist services harmoniously blend with nature. For lovers of archaeology, at only 15 kilometers from Kemer, at the foothills of Mount Tahtali, is Fazilis, the city with three ports, once an important commercial center. Aqueducts, public baths, the Agora, a theater, and Hadrian's Door are reminiscent of a very active city and in great expansion. The South Port offers a magnificent view of Tahtali Mount. Is certainly a well-known and distinctive tourist product that offers much more than a simple sailing cruise. It's a spiritual journey, similar to what the 1960s Turkish intellectuals used to embark on. A blue sea, uncontaminated deserted beaches, archaeological sites accessible only by boat, and the atmosphere of ancient history almost palpable on the excursion paths along the coast. The sharing of travel experiences with your companions, whom you start to get acquainted with moment after moment, and more, Turkish traditions and cuisine, everyday cooking that's daily enlivened by the chef on board, and finally, a comfortable boat, confidently sailing along with the Meltemi, the reliable summer wind that blows on the turquoise coast. To navigate around the Eastern Mediterranean means getting through one surprise after another. Except for the olive tree, the vine, wheat, and all the other fruit plants that are commonly known as Mediterranean but actually originated elsewhere. Oranges, lemons, and mandarins came from the Far East and were imported by the Arabs. These large trees with Greek names like eucalyptus come from Australia. The cypresses that the Tuscans adore and are proud of actually come from Persia. Moreover, the tomato is from Peru, chili is from Guyana. Mice is from Mexico. Rice is an Arab gift, and beans, potatoes, and peaches are from China and then from Iran. In other words, a lot of commonplaces are disproved and confirmed that the Mediterranean has forever been the major reference point of our civilization. We originated from the sea, and we want to conclude our journey there. The Turkish coast we visited is in full boom. All sorts of buildings like villas, residences, hotels are springing up everywhere, though this frenzy has not reached the extent of the Mediterranean western coast. The landscape along the coast is still wild and immaculate, hence don't expect to find French or Spanish-style promenades here. During the summer, the inhabitants of the coastline villages devote themselves to tourism and welcome foreigners willing to find a quiet place. In Turkey, it's still possible to enjoy a nautical tourism worthy of the name. Coastline navigation, good cruising, sailing, comfort at sea, and well-organized and efficient moorings, practical to fully appreciate this exceptional and timeless natural beauty. Is it worthy of all your attention if you're lucky enough to navigate through these routes leading east?